Hey you guys, this is the Kaizen Man welcoming you to the Kaizen Project. Today's video is a very special video. As you can see, I'm standing in my kitchen and this is something that I wanted to share with you for quite some time now. I love to cook and I wanted to make a video about cooking. And one of the things that I've kind of gotten really good at cooking over the years, not to brag at all, but I have worked in steakhouses forever and I've seen steaks being cooked in many different ways, cooked on a grill, cooked broiled, sous vide, pan seared, you name it, I've seen it happen. Today's video is about how to cook a steak. And I want to share this with you because this is something that I think people should really know how to do, is how to cook a steak. It's simple, but it's not easy. What you want to try and do with your steak is, first thing, you want to make sure that it's at room temperature. So let it out of the fridge, let it sit for a while. What I usually like to do is have the steak marinating in salt and pepper, and maybe a bit of flavor if you want to add garlic, rosemary is great as well. And the reason why you want to add salt is because the salt actually breaks down the proteins, which makes your steak that much more tender. But let's backtrack a little bit here. The key to picking steak is you want to consider three things. With steak, you want to look at the tenderness, the flavor, and the marbling. Now, what's marbling? Marbling is when you look at a piece of steak, you see those little white lines that run through in between the proteins. Those are little bits of fat, and those are actually what give you flavor in the steak. And my mouth is watering as I'm talking about this. And there's many different kinds of steak that you can choose from. The different types of steak out there on the market, there's sirloin, strip loin, ribeyes, filet mignons, and all of these have some variable of how much flavor they have, how much tenderness they have, and what is the marbling on them. If you like steak which is really tender, almost buttery, then go with a filet mignon. Filet mignons are the most tender of steaks, but they don't have a lot of flavor to them, which is why a lot of times they're served with a piece of bacon wrapped around them just to give them that extra bit of flavor. On the other end of the spectrum, you have ribeyes, which have quite a bit of fat on them. They have a lot of marbling and they're not recommended to be eaten all the time by doctors, but those do have a lot of flavor. Somewhere in the middle of those two spectrums of being really lean and really fatty exists the strip loin. The New York strip loin is one of the most popular cuts of steak. It's called the king of steaks because it's the right combination of flavor and tenderness. Another really popular cut of steak is a sirloin, which is what we have here today. The sirloin comes from the rump of the animal. It's typically quite a bit flavorful, not the most tender cut of meat, but it is something which I like to cook with because it's easy to cook. The proteins don't break down too quickly, which means you can get the skin nice and seared and still keep the interior to be at a medium rare. And when you're cooking your steak, you wanna be mindful of what you're eating with it. Steak itself can be quite heavy, so I don't typically like to eat mashed potatoes or a lot of carbs with it, especially starchy carbs. So what I'm cooking with that here are some peppers. Keep it nice and light, also adds a bit of color to the plate as well. So if you're eating healthy, you're on a keto diet or a paleo diet, and you'd want to get some healthy substitute for your carbs, these are good options, and I'm going to cut them up and saute them in the pan which the steak is cooked in, so they get some flavor and also get some healthy vegetables on the side as well. And just a quick note here as well, if you're cooking your steak and you want to pair some red wine with it, you can go ahead and click the link in this video. And I talk about the basics of wine, how to pick your wine, what kind of wine varietals are there. You've heard the word tannin being thrown around, and I talk about that in detail in this video. So you can go ahead and check that out, and that will give you a sense of why you pair red wine with steak. But for this video, just to keep it simple, I would suggest going with something like a Cabernet Sauvignon, a Malbec, a Merlot if you like. Really, any red wine which has a bit of medium to heavy body will do. When it comes to actually cooking the steak, this is important. You want to get the pan super hot. I mean really scary hot, because the hotter your pan is, the easier it is for the skin of the steak to sear as soon as you put it on. And you want to get that nice browning, the caramelization of the steak. And the reason why that's important is that when your steak skin gets nice and brown, it actually denatures the proteins, which starts to unwind the proteins and makes them more tender and easier to eat. So for that, the oil that you want to use is important. I recommend using a vegetable or a canola oil. The reason for that is that if you're using butter or olive oil, those oils are typically at a much lower smoking point. And when the pan gets really hot, those are going to burn and add a bitter flavor to your steak, which is not good. So go with a vegetable or a canola oil when you're cooking steak. We'll be right back. All right, well, that's that. Steak is ready, and I'm going to dig into it. As you can see, it looks to be a perfect, perfect medium rare, and that was easy to cook. That took me a total of 6 minutes, so in the time that you watch this video, you can literally make the steak. The key is to not move your steak around too much. Just make sure that it's getting the nice sear that it needs to. And in case you're wondering what the sauce underneath it, it's a bit of mint sauce with yogurt that I just kind of smeared on, trying to make it look fancy. But as you can see, my plating skills still need some work. But if you enjoyed that video, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to the channel because I do like to put out videos. And if you have any particular topic that you want to learn about, or if there's something that you want me to make a video about, please leave a comment below. And until next time, thank you so much for watching. It's the Kaizen Man signing out.